We've seen a lot of different innovation models within healthcare. You have accelerators, incubators, you have internal innovation arms, you have external innovation arms. So, you know, you chose the accelerator model. Why did you go that route? I mean, it's exciting what you're talking about, because, you know, it's pool. I mean, essentially the organization, they're telling you what they want to work on, which is a phenomenal model. But why that model versus one of the other models that's out there?
So first, let me start and say that what we really started with, which was sort of ahead of the accelerator, was we have a rich history of technology transfer and really supporting our faculty and the unbelievable ideas that they have and helping them to, you know, commercialize and bring to market, you know, those ideas, those solutions, and frankly, those sort of health discoveries that, you know, wonderful things that have really sort of transformed how healthcare is delivered. The new part is in looking at outside innovation or innovation that was on the outside, recognizing that perhaps we didn't have an exclusivity on good ideas. How could we help those companies really sort of get to the next level? And what we really discovered in talking to them is that the best and the brightest in entrepreneurs were a little bit intimidated by healthcare. Face it, it's a little bit of a black box. It's not really clear exactly what goes on. And, you know, we were sort of scratching our head of why are some of the best and brightest building more social media apps and more games? And there's nothing wrong with social media apps and games. The world probably does need more of them. But wouldn't it be even cooler if we got some of those folks to want to solve not just problems in healthcare, but problems in healthcare for like acute and chronic patients? I don't think we needed another band for somebody who's super well to be even more well and perhaps, you know, beat their personal best in a marathon. Again, there's a place in the world for those things, but I'm not sure that a health system like Cedars needed the help to propel those. So we picked an accelerator because we truly wanted the companies to get this 90-day intense period to accelerate their idea and see what happens. And by the way, for some companies, they realize in 60 days of the 90 days that, oh my gosh, this wasn't a good idea at all. We need to go do something else. And, you know, while it's easy to sort of talk about that sort of, you know, at a high level sort of after the fact, it's painful for the companies to go through. But, you know, they turned around, they told us later, and some of them are our biggest supporters and our biggest sort of mentors in the network that we've built, that they otherwise would have toiled around for 2 years before they figured out it wasn't the right market. Obviously, there's plenty that, you know, we've helped sort of accelerate them and propel them by giving them direct access to, you know, quote unquote, what is the wet lab of Cedars, and they really can sort of understand what they need to do.